Magandang umaga po ulit mga kaguro sa ating mga kabataang Pilipino na nag-aaral sa Mathematics 8. Itutuloy po natin ang ating leksyon tungkol sa Rectangular Coordinate System in Week 4, which is based in our MELC or Most Essential Learning Competency. Okay, so here is our Rectangular Coordinate System, the parts, the four quadrants, the origin, the x-axis, and the y-axis. Okay, so before that, so pwede po muna natin i-subscribe ang ating YouTube channel. Okay, then click the notification bell. Okay, so ngayon po, ang ating pong gagawin ay ang kung paano isulat ang linear equation to slope intercept form. We have also slope of a line. Slope of a line wherein we are going to get the m which is equal to rise over run. Given po yung ating graph ng equation of the line. And we have also, we are going to get the slope of a line given the two points. Okay? And we are going to write linear equation AX plus BY equals C, o yung tinatawag nating standard form of linear equation, to Y is equal to MX plus B or vice versa. Y is equal to MX plus B. Ito naman po yung tinatawag nating slope intercept form. Okay? So, yan po. So, balik po tayo sa ating linear equation to slope intercept form. So, yun po yung given natin. Ano po? So, let us solve, which is the slope is 4. The slope is 4. And then, negative 4. And then, we have y-intercept which is equals to 3. So, ang gagawin lang po natin dyan ay ating pong isa-substitute into equation mx plus b. Okay? So, ito po siya, di ba po? So, the slope of the line is negative 4, y-intercept is 3, and y is equal to mx plus b. So, once again, ito pong negative 4, ito po yung value ng m. Then, ito pong 3, siya po yung value ng b. Okay? Which is the y-intercept. Pag sinabi pong nating y-intercept, ibig sabihin, 0 po yung kanyang x. And then, the value of b is the value of y. Kaya po siya y-intercept. Okay? So, this time, we have y is equal to, substitute only the given, we have negative 4, so negative 4x plus 3. So, ganun lang po siya kasimple. So, this is our slope-intercept form. Given yung m, and we have the given value of b, which is the y-intercept. Hindi po ba? Ang dali. Okay, another example. We have y is equal to, ano pong value ng ating m? Which is 1 half. So, that is 1 half x. Plus, the value of y-intercept, which is b, is negative 1. So, yan po. Kapag sinubstitute po natin siya sa ating pong equation, we have y is equal to 1 half x plus negative 1. So, the simplest form, ating pong isi-simplify. So, we have 1 half x minus 1. So, yun na po yung ating equation. Okay? So, di po ba? Napakadali siya. Ano ha? So, go back po tayo sa ating given. So, this time naman po, ang ating pong gagawin naman. So, okay na po tayo sa kapag given natin ay slope and y-intercept. Kaya na po natin kunin ang slope equation of the line. This time naman po, ang kukunin natin ay yung slope of the line given po yung graph ng equation. So as you can see, so rise over run lang po siya, di po ba? Rise over run. Okay. So for example, number 1. So rise over run, yung ating pong value ng, ang value po ng change in y, yung rise po muna, bilangin natin, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 units po, no? So m is equal to 5. Okay? And then, yung run naman po natin from here, we have 1, 2, 3, 4. So, therefore, we have 5, 4. And, as you can see, ang ating pong graph ay going down. Diba? From left, that is going down. So, therefore, ang ating pong slope of the line ay negative 5 over 4. So, yun lang po. Ano ha? So, negative 5 over 4. So, this is for number 1. How about number 2? Number 2 naman po tayo. So, for number 2, given is, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, 7 po yung ating rise. So, M is equal to 7. Over, ang ating namang pong run from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, 6 po siya. And then, from left, that is going up. O no? So, therefore, that is positive 7 over 6. So, ganun lang po kadali siya, no? Negative, positive 7 over 6. So, that is the slope of the line. So, ganun lang po kadali kapag given natin ay graph of the equation. So, we are going to count the rise over run. So, pwede rin naman po siyang kunin natin ang point 1 at saka yung point 2, yung ating coordinates x and y. And then, perform the formula. So, ito po yung ating formula. Kapag ganun lang po ang ating pong, given na po yung 2 points, ang gagamitin naman natin ay yung formula, which is m is equal to y sub 2 minus y sub 1 over x sub 2 minus x sub 1. So, for example, we have a number 6. The given is 2, 1, and 4, 2. So, m is equal to, sabi natin, m is equal to y sub 1. Ito yung ating y, sabihin natin, ito yung x sub 2 and then y sub 2. Then, ito naman yung x sub 1, y sub 1. Okay? So, yan. So, y sub 2 minus y sub 1 over x sub 2 minus x sub 1. Kaya nga po, siya ay rise, di ba? Rise over run. Kasi yung y, yung po yung pataas, di po ba? Yun yung vertical number line. Then, ito pong run, yung change in x, the x-axis, ito yung horizontal number line. Okay? Kaya po, change in rise over run. Change in y over change in x. So, therefore, m is equal to, so, 2, substitute na po natin, 2 minus 1 over 4 minus 2. So, therefore, we have 1 over 2. So, 1 half po yung ating slope of the line. Now, pwede po ba magkapalit itong dalawa? Pwedeng magkapalit. For example, itong gawin nating x sub 2, ito yung y sub 2, then ito yung x sub 1, at ito yung y sub 1. Pwede ba? So, let us see. So, m is equal to, so, baliktarin natin, 1 minus 2. Diba? 1 minus 2. And then, change in x, we have 2 minus 4. So, m is equal to, 1 minus 2 is negative 1. And 2 minus 4 is negative 2. Then, we can cancel the number, the negative sign. Negative divided by negative is positive. So, m is equal to 1 half. So, ganun din po. Pareho lang sila. Kahit po, pagkabalikta rin natin yung ating, what we call this, the using the x sub 2 and y sub 2 and x sub 1, y sub 1. Or yung tinatawag natin, ito yung sabihin natin 0.2, then ito yung 0.1. Ano po? So, okay lang po siya. Okay? Another one. Let's say we have negative 2, 3, and 0, negative 1. So, therefore, we have, sabi natin, negative 2, 3, and 0, negative 1. Okay. So, in our formula, we have m is equal to 3 minus negative 1. So, 3 minus negative 1. So, yan na. And then, negative 2 minus 0. Okay, now, so 3 minus negative 1, proceed to addition, then change the sign of the subtrahend. Magiging na po siyang positive. Then, over negative 2. So, therefore, 3 added to 1 is 4 over negative 2. So, therefore, we have now 4 divided by negative 2 is negative 2. So, yun na po yung ating slope of the line. Negative 2. So, kaya po kung igagrap natin siya, maaaring ang kalabasan niya, ito yung y, then x. So, siya po ay papaganyan. Ano ha? Okay. So, going down ang kanyang graph in the rectangular coordinate system. Okay? So, ganun lang po siya kadali. Ano po? Another one. Ano yung isa pa nating learning competency na kailangan nating makuha in our week 4. We have writing linear equation AX plus BY equals C, which is the standard form, to Y equals MX plus B, which is our slope intercept form, and vice versa. Okay, so for example, we have 2x plus y equals 13. So 2x plus y equals 13. So gaya po ng ating mga naunang ginawa nung last week, tayo po ay nag-solve ng linear equation or rational equation, di ba? So, we have now 2x plus y equals 13. So, y is equal to, ito po, using transposition or addition property of equality or subtraction property of equality. So, subtract both sides by negative 2x. Na. Or in transposition, we have 13 minus 2x. Or y is equal to negative 2x plus 13. Kasi po, ito yung ating m, di ba? Then, ito naman yung ating b. Okay? So, that is y is equal to mx plus b. Okay? So, yun na po. Ang final answer natin ay y is equal to negative 2x plus 13. So, ganun lang po kasimple. Ano po? Another example. Let's say we have, so, madali na po yung number 2. Yung number 6. Gawin po natin yung number 6. That is, 3x minus 6y equals 18. Okay, so therefore we have now negative 6y equals negative 3x plus 18. Ganun po, di ba? Then divide both sides by negative 6. By negative 6. So therefore, makakancel na po natin yung negative 6 na numerical coefficient ng y. So, ano na lang po matitira? Y is equal to negative 3 divided by negative 6 is positive na po. Both negative numbers. So, that is negative 1/2 x minus 18 divided by 6 is negative 6. That is negative 3. So, ito na po yung ating final answer. Okay po? So, yan yung standard form into slope-intercept form. So, ngayon naman po, ang given natin ay slope-intercept. Kabaligtaran naman po, ano ha? So, kung kabaligtaran naman siya, y is equal to, for example, we have so, for example, let's say number 7, we have y is equal to negative 3 over 2x minus 4. So, for example po, ganun yung ating given. Ano po? So, ang atin naman pong gagawin ay ax plus by equals c. Ganun naman po, ano ha? So, this time, multiply both sides by the denominator. So, 2. Para pumalis yung fraction form. So, 2 times y is 2y. And then, i-distribute naman natin itong 2 to these terms. Dalawa po, distributive property. So, cancel na po siya na ano na lang po matitira? Negative 3x. And then, negative 4 times 2, that is negative 8. And then, after that, atin na po siyang ililipat sa kabila. Ano po? So, therefore, we have 3x plus 2y equals negative 8. So, ito na po yung ating linear equation, standard form. In the form of ax plus by equals c. So, kapag pin-identify sa inyo, what is the value of a? So, the value of a is 3. What is the value of b? 2. And the value of c is negative 8. Yun lang po. So, ganun lang po siya. Kadali, ano po. So, sana itong ating video tutorial ay nakatulong para sa ating rectangular coordinate system in week 4. At don't forget to subscribe our TV channel.